in Zimbabwe, our position, though it is evolving, but the position has always been that, you know, it is the issue of homosexuality is generally unacceptable because it is actually illegal in the country. So that's what has been the discussion all along. But with the coming of the commission, we tend to see shifts in emphasis. For example, now it's more like we're discussing about the unit of the church rather than just narrowing the discussion on the issue of human sexuality. And that is now beginning to be a bit confusing because definitely people want to belong to the United Methodist. But at the same time, from our biblical and cultural point of view, issues of same-sex marriage are not as acceptable in our part of the world. Our understanding as delegates, especially as we were coming up to the General Conference of 2016, what we were focusing on was the issue of human sexuality. That's what was central to us. And our understanding as African delegates then was that the request or the decision of the General Conference to defer any action on issues to do with sexuality was to provide an opportunity for the Council of Bishops, you know, to kind of guide the church on this issue because definitely it was going to be divisive and it has always been divisive. So we supported that in terms of voting to say, okay, let's give time and space to our Episcopal leaders to kind of help us come out of this. And that's how the commission on the way forward was created. That was our understanding. And the agenda was to focus on issues on human sexuality. What appears to be confusing now is that we tend to see a repackaging of what we were supposed to get. Because now the talk and emphasis is on the oneness of the church rather than on the sexuality issue. And that's where it is becoming confusing for most African delegations. Because, for example, if I choose any of the options given, it appears as if I'm taking a choice on the unit of the church rather than a choice on sexuality.